So, would any one of you like to volunteer to answer a couple of questions, follow-up questions? As seen
Yes,
by,
ma'am.
okay, so Monica, my question to you is, what is the importance of teaching cooking, sewing, and woodworking in schools?
Well, I think there are many important factors of learning cooking. Ma'am, can you please repeat cooking? What?
Cooking, sewing, woodworking, all these subjects. Cooking, sewing, woodworking in schools.
Yeah, so well, I think there are many important factors of learning cooking, sewing, and woodworkings for to the children, because during this phase they can learn when they are alone. Suppose they are not with their parents, so they know how to cook and feed themselves, not just themselves, but also if they are having their younger siblings, so they can also feed them. Other factors about sowing is like planting is very important factor where you can plant growing plants is very important, because as part of environment, it is our duty, human duty, to plant as many as plants as possible.
Okay, so here I'm going. I've shared my dictionary with you, right? Can you see it? This is the word I used. So, cooking, sewing, woodworking, right? So, it is not sowing plants. Okay, so that is the correct pronunciation of this word. And this is sewing, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So it is have to stop the share.
No, ma'am, we are not able to see the screen.
You didn't see this dictionary which I showed you
No,
here?
ma'am.
No?
No, ma'am. No.
Now can you see?
Yes,
Yeah.
now we can see.
Okay. So you can see here pronunciation. It's not Sioux. Okay. It's so cooking, sewing, woodworking. It's not sewing. Okay.
So you
Sewing.
mean stitching
Yes,
clothes.
yes. Okay. See.
My mother taught me how to sew.
My mother taught me how to sew.
My mother taught me how to sew.
So it's not Sioux, right? So
Yes.
that is what I was speaking. Okay. Stop share. Like, okay. So that was it. So you took the question in the wrong this thing direction. And now I'll be sharing my other file with you so that you can see this is an essay question. Okay. This is an essay question. Oh, Nora. What do you want? Okay. Importance of teaching cooking, sewing, and woodworking. The essay that came was students in school should learn academic subjects and pass exams. Other skills such as cookery, dressmaking, and woodwork can be learned well from family. Do you agree or disagree? Now, if you know the importance of cooking, sewing, and woodworking, you can disagree and say these subjects should be taught, right? Your one essay is done. You'll have the points. Okay. Can you see this file which I've shared right now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So what is the importance of teaching cooking, sewing, and woodworking? What is the importance? Read it. One of you will read it out.
Ma'am, can I read?
Yes, sure. Why not?
Firstly, craft education improves the intelligence level of students. Recent researchers claim that there is a direct correlation between eye coordination and the development of the brain.
Yes.
And second, also students can learn maths through real-life applications. They need math when they are measuring, designing, and planning their projects. Third one, it also teaches students to concentrate and focus. This helps students who have problems with sitting still and listening in class. Fourth one, another very good advantage of craft education is that it takes away gender stereotypes. Both boys and girls learn how to knit and sew and cook.
Yes.
Both boys and girls learn how to woodwork and hammer and use power tools. And last one is, it gives additional career choice.
Career. It's career. Okay.
Yeah, it's career choice.
Okay.
Career choice.
So now you see, if you have such good points inside you, you can answer the question very well. And you can also write the essay very nicely. Do you agree or disagree with me in that, in this aspect?
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Yes, ma'am.
So surely, you know, when you are doing speaking, you're also doing writing. And when you're doing writing, you're also doing speaking. Right? So now come to the next next student who will answer the next question. I'll throw the question after you volunteer. Amit. Okay, Amit, your question is, what is the importance of arts, drama, creative writing in schools?
Well, there are a number of benefits which are related with arts, music, and learning creative writings. First of all, by learning these skills, one can learn about the basic things about writing, and as such, they can be more creative. And by doing such activities, one should be able to express him or herself in a much better way.
Tell me, you've used the word should be able to.
Yes.
Hindi mein kya kehna chahte ho?
Ma'am, Hindi mein ye kehna chahta hoon ki by learning these skills, ek banda apne aap ko ek better way mein express kar sakta hai.
Kar sakta hai ki English kya hogi?
He or she will be able to express.
Will be able to or can be able to, right?
Yes.
Not should be able to. Should is suggestion.
Okay.
So okay. Your modal verb that you used was wrong. See, there are 8 modal verbs in English. 8.
Okay.
Can, could, will, would, may, might, shall, should. These are very important to use correctly in writing as well as in speaking. Okay.
Right, ma'am. Ji.
These modal verbs are very important in writing also. They change the meaning altogether. Okay. Now, Amit, you will see the advantages. This essay was seen very recently. I think in November or December in some part of the world in general training. Okay.
Okay.
So just read these 4 points which I have written. Can you read? Can you see the file?
Yeah. The most important benefit of art education in schools is that it improves vocabulary, communication, and memory. Research has found a link between arts education and success in other subjects. Second one is, secondly, art education helps in the holistic development of children. Arts exercise the right side of the brain, whereas academic subjects exercise the left side. According to expert, it is necessary to exercise both sides of the brain to maintain balanced emotions. The arts unite life and learning and are essential in the development of the whole person. Another big advantage is that these subjects bring out the creativity of the children. And when such hidden abilities are exposed in school time, then those with exceptional talent can encourage to adopt it as a profession later on in life. Last but not least, such subjects are stress busters. In the highly competitive era of today, pressure of academic subjects is too high. Arts like music, drama, and creative writing breaks the monotony of tough academic studies.
Very good. So now you know the points. You can speak out a better answer and you can also write a better essay. Correct? Okay. Next, who will answer? Any one of you? Please come out in the open. Nobody wants to answer. Koi nahi answer karna chahta. To jo bhi karna chahta. Amit, aap hi agle question.
Can I?
Sure, why not? Come on. Okay. What is the effect of communication technology on reading and writing skills? Now, this is an essay. You know that this is an essay. Okay. Communication technology is having an effect on reading and writing skills. Okay. Some people say it has negative effect. Do you agree or disagree? So you can say I agree, and then you can put all the negative effects. So I'm just asking you straight away, what is the effect of communication skills on the reading and writing skills of children?
Nowadays, communication has myriad benefits. As
what word have you used?
Myriad benefits.
Do you know the word many?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now if you use many benefits, you will get a 9 band. My ride is no word, and you are spoiling the whole speaking because of using a word.
Okay, ma'am.
Now just wait. Did you want to use this word?
Yes, ma'am.
Myriad.
Extremely large. Bahut jyada bade, bahut jyada numbers. Do you want to say this, or many would be enough?
Many would be enough, ma'am.
It would be more than enough. You are spoiling your show by using this word and using it with the wrong pronunciation on top of that.
Okay, ma'am.
पता है क्या, when you know, when this is the problem. अगर students एक दिन में ना vocabulary को का blackout कर देना, तो अच्छे band आ जाए एक महीने में. एक महीना तो हमको ये भुलाने में लगा देते हैं कि vocabulary को भूल जाओ भाई, grammar और उस पे focus करो, वो ज्यादा मायने रखती हैं चीजें. Pronunciation, flow, fluency in speaking. It will not matter whether you have not used big words. You speak nicely, okay? Impressively, simple words, you will get better bands.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Stop share, kahan se karna hai? Stop share here. Chalo, ab bolo.
Communication is, technology is helping a lot in communication nowadays. We have so many applications through which we can communicate with others in easy way. It was not possible in the early days, in the past time, but now it has become easy. Like sitting at home, people can talk to each other, even not facing each other.
See, we are talking about the effect of communication technology on the reading and writing skills. You are talking about effects of communication technology in general.
Okay, ma'am.
So, you know, you have to focus more on the question, and you have to see, agar aapke dimag mein ye chal raha hai na ki mujhe ye word dalna hai, to aap baki sab cheezein ignore kar doge.
Yes, ma'am.
Theek hai? Haan, ab bolo.
Sorry, ma'am. Like I have to talk about writing and reading.
How reading and writing skills. What is the effect of communication technology on the reading and writing skills? And is the effect positive or negative? Just answer this. As simple as that.
Actually, I'm unable to make points. मुझे समझ नहीं आ के क्या points इसमें.
देखो, reading और writing skills पे आपने इसके effects बोलने हैं ना? तो मैं अब आपको एक शेयर करती हूँ फाइल. नाउ रीड आउट दिस.
नेगेटिव इफेक्ट्स. फर्स्ट, इट एनकरेजेस साइबर स्लैंग, विच मींस शॉर्टकट्स, ऑल्टरनेटिव वर्ड्स और इवन सिंबल्स यूज्ड टू कन्वे थॉट्स इन एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डॉक्यूमेंट. द प्रॉब्लम अराइजेस व्हेन दिस स्लैंग फाइंड्स इट्स वे इनटू फॉर्मल राइटिंग. For example, abbreviations such as LOL, C-U-L-8-R, and because are grossly wrong when used in school essays. Okay. Second, moreover, the autocorrect feature fixes their mistakes, so they don't even realize that they wrote something wrong. Third, due to technological development, reading habits are fast vanishing into thin air. Students now spend more hours browsing the net, playing games on their handsets, and writing non-stop SMSs to their contacts. Fourth, the lack of reading culture among our youth nowadays has greatly affected quality of graduates being produced. Consequently, The influence of electronic media on the reading habits of pupils has become an issue of concern.
तो आपको रीडिंग एंड राइटिंग स्किल्स पे आपको ऐसे पूछा जाता है जो ऐसे ऊपर लिखा हुआ है. Some people think that increasing communication usage of computers and mobile phones by young people has had a negative effect on their reading and writing skills. To what extent do you agree or disagree? You can strongly agree, okay? And you can put these points in 2 or 3 paragraphs. Your essay is done?
Yes, ma'am.
And can you answer the question also better like this?
Yes, ma'am.
In speaking?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what is more important? Words or ideas and grammar? Tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Ideas, grammar is more important.
Much more important. Okay. Next question is, what is the importance of vocational education? Who would like to answer this? What is the importance of vocational education? You know what is vocational education?
Yes, ma'am. Like curriculum activities.
What aids you in getting jobs like carpentry, plumbing, all these are vocations.
Practical skills, basically.
Practical skills, yes, basically, yes. So what is the importance of vocational education? मुझे लगता है आज की क्लास आप बहुत बच्चों की आंखें खोल देगी कि अच्छा ऐसे तैयारी करनी है दोनों चीजों की, राइटिंग की और स्पीकिंग की. ठीक है?
Yes, ma'am.
फिर कोई प्रॉब्लम ही नहीं आनी आपको. आपको लगना है ऐसे लिख लेंगे, आइडियाज हैं, स्पीकिंग कर लेंगे, आइडियाज है. ठीक है, चलो बोलो इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ वोकेशनल एजुकेशन. हु वुड लाइक टू स्पीक? Swathi, would you like to answer any question?
Hi, ma'am. Yeah, I will try.
Yes, sure.
Vocational education right from higher classes will help the students to understand the job very well, actually. It means that they can include their studies in a practical way where they can learn another skill that will help them to get a better job in future. Beyond that, after these, most of the time vocational courses will be 3 or 3 maximum 3 years. So at the earliest they will get a job and that will help them to gain more experience for the future. And
very good. And you know, I was just thinking you can add another point also now here, that if students know these vocational skills, they will not be their dependence on others. Even if they don't want to adopt it as a career, their dependence on others will decrease, and they'll be able to manage their work at home also efficiently. Up there is a leaking tap in the house,
they can work on that.
What we have to do is we are waiting for the plumber to come and do it. But if you know a little bit of plumbing, you can do it on your own. You don't have to wait.
Yes.
A little bit of carpentry, a little bit of plumbing, these minor tools at home, they can help a long way in decreasing the dependence on people like this.
And ma'am, one more thing I would like to add, that these type of workers are less in number nowadays. So
yes, they are more in demand.
So yeah, more in demand. So if students are choosing, if they are interested to choose such vocational training, that will be good.
I'll give you a very good example. You know, we our generator you broke down. And I'm talking of, 10, 15 years ago, we called a mechanic for the generator and he did something to it. He took about half an hour to 1 hour. And that time, you know, our fees as a doctor was 100 rupees, okay, per patient. And that plumber took 900 rupees. And my husband said that you are taking 900, even we don't charge that much.
Mm.
So he says, you know what he said? Exact words. He said, doctors like you are a plenty.
Yeah.
but you will not find another mechanic like me.
Yeah. That's very true. So
that is exactly what he said. And he took his money. And so, you know, if that is, you are very right. You can always say these points also and give examples. Tell a story like this also. Okay. You can do anything in your speaking.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you can do anything. You can add examples, add a story.
Yeah, ma'am. I can add examples.
Yes,
yeah.
You can do that.
Yeah.
Okay. So these are the essay questions. Nowadays, a lot of people in college are doing academic study. We should encourage them to learn vocational skills, for example, to become plumbers. See, the pronunciation is not plumber. It is plumber. It is be silent here. Okay. Plumbers and electricians. Do you agree or disagree? So this question answered. Some people think that to be successful, you need to get a university education, whereas others say it is not true. You can talk about vocational education here also. You do not need to get a university education. And here you can say, some people believe that studying in a college or university is the best way for students to prepare for their future career. Others think they should leave school as soon as possible and develop their career through work experience. Again, here it is all about vocational education, right? So university and college education versus vocational education, importance of vocational education, you can do these points, and the importance of university education. So one of you, can you read these points for other students to listen? Anybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, come on.
Importance of vocational education. Young people can start earning money soon and become independent. They will be able to afford their own house and start a family soon. Second, the terms of their career, young will have the chance to gain real experience and learn practical skills related to their choice profession. This may lead to promotion and a successful career. Importance of tertiary education. Firstly, academic qualifications are required in many professions. For example, it is impossible to become a doctor, teacher, or lawyer without having a relevant degree. Second, another advantage of graduating from a university is that it gives a person more choices when it comes to choosing a job. Third, university graduates also tend to earn higher salaries than those with fewer qualifications. Fourth, furthermore, the job market is becoming increasingly competitive, and sometimes there are hundreds of applicants for one position in a company. Young people who do not have qualifications for a university or college will not able to compete. What is more, those who working in the construction work or as a car mechanics will always have to work under those who have civil and mechanical engineering degrees.
So, आपको ये समझ आ गए points सारे सबको? Got them all?
Yes, ma'am.
Now you can attempt these essays also, and you can answer these questions also better. Now, what the next question is? Okay, should the importance of healthy food and healthy eating be taught in schools? This is the question. This is a follow-up question, believe me. Yes. Or should it be taught by parents only at home? Who will answer it?
Ma'am, may I?
Sure, why not?
Ma'am, parents and teachers play a very important role in individual holistic development. So they their role are equally in the development of their children. Like children spend most of time with their teacher as well as with their parents. So when they go their school, that time teacher should tell them about the healthy food, like they should check the lunch box of their children, which they bring for eating, and they should also encourage them to eat healthy food and more green vegetables, as well as parents also cook.
So my question was that should the healthy eating and healthy food be taught in schools, importance of this be taught in schools? You should be very direct in answering. Yes, it should be taught in schools as well as at home, because healthy eating and healthy food is very important to be taught to today's children. Okay, teaching it only at home would not be enough. Parents, children don't listen to their parents much. Okay, so schools also should take the initiative. You know, there are schools here where it is compulsory. I just came to know a few days back. It is compulsory to take only green vegetables and chapati in the lunch box. Nothing else, no sandwiches, nothing else allowed. Can you believe it? They are encouraging children to eat green vegetables. They check the lunch boxes. Is it there in other schools also? I don't know that.
School that time, ma'am, teachers are not allowed us that you should bring pickle in your lunch box. You should bring vegetable.
Yes, yes. So that should be there. Okay. Aapne bola, ye answer, who gave this answer?
Aman.
Bete, mujhe pata nahi chal raha, naam bol do.
Aman, ma'am.
Aman. Aman, aapne bola individual holistic development. Hindi karo iski?
एक जन का पूरा डेवलपमेंट
नहीं नहीं आपने बोला पेरेंट्स एंड टीचर्स प्ले अ रोल इन द इंडिविजुअल होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट आपने ये बोला था ना इस सेंटेंस की हिंदी करो पूरे की
पेरेंट्स एंड टीचर्स प्ले अ रोल इन अ होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट इन इंडिविजुअल लाइफ
लाइक हिंदी करो ना इसकी पेरेंट्स और टीचर्स
रोल
की होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट में रोल प्ले करते हैं यही है ना आपकी हिंदी
यस मैम
हाँ तो इंडिविजुअल की जिस सेंटेंस में ट्रांसलेशन में की आ जाए उसमें इंडिविजुअल रहेगा कि इंडिविजुअल अपोस्ट्रोफी एस हो जाएगा
इंडिविजुअल्स
हाँ ये बताने के लिए आपको बोल रही थी कि हिंदी करो ठीक है
okay.
आपको इंडिविजुअल्स होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट इन द पर्सन होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट ठीक है बाकी आपने बहुत अच्छा बोला है और ये आपको डायरेक्ट आंसर देना है आपको सीधा पहली लाइन में बोलना है कि बोथ शुड प्ले रोल इन दैट बिकॉज यू नो हेल्दी ईटिंग एंड हेल्दी फूड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी टॉट टू चिल्ड्रन एज इट इज चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टुवर्ड्स जंक फूड विच इज नॉट गुड फॉर देयर हेल्थ
यस
लाइक दैट यू कैन आंसर ठीक है एंड ओनली पेरेंट्स टीचिंग दिस वुड नॉट बी इनफ Okay, and ye next essay hai, some people think that schools do not do enough to teach young people about how to look after their health. Schools do not do enough. You can say yes, they do not do enough. Unko zyada karna chahiye aur fir usi ki importance bol dena ki apni health ki look after karne ki kya importance hai. Theek hai? So in that way you will be answering this question also. Agree karte ho to fir schools agar kuch kar rahe hain to aap apni examples deke agree karke bhi essay bana sakte ho. That will be good. Okay. Next question to me, to one of you. किसने देना आंसर देखो ये पांच essays हैं जिनमें एक सेट ऑफ आइडियाज कर लेंगे यू कैन आंसर ऑल दीज फाइव questions. ओके ओके what इज द importance ऑफ हिस्ट्री इन schools? What इज द importance ऑफ टीचिंग हिस्ट्री इन schools? बोलो what इज द importance ऑफ टीचिंग हिस्ट्री इन schools?
मैम मैं
Yes, sure. Why not? कोई और नहीं आंसर करा आप ही करते जाओ कोई
Okay. Well, there are number of benefits which are related to teaching of history in school at school level.
Yes.
The primary one is that by learning history, one can learn about the past of his or her country, that how they have what the incidents has happened in the past, so that they can learn about the life of their ancestors. Beside that, by learning history, one can also develop an interest in that and can pursue a career by opting for a job in different museums and can teach the importance of about these to the coming generation.
Very good. Okay. Now you can read out this answer also. Importance of study of history. There are 5 points.
Okay. So ma'am, I'm having one query.
Yes.
I need to discuss two points or I need to discuss some more points also.
See, for speaking only one point, go ahead, give an example, that will be more than enough. But for write essays, you need 2 or 3 points. You know, you may not remember all the points in the exam. So if you read here, you need 5 points, you will forget 1 or 2. Your essay will be very good with just 2 or 3 points, total essay. Okay, right. Believe me, that is, you don't need a lot of points. But the purpose is that when you have read 4 or 5, at least you will remember 1 or 2. 3 right?
Because here I was about to mention one of the skills, that history repeat itself, and as such one can learn from the mistakes of the past.
Yes, you can. This is very common. You've read it many times over and over again. So this statement has become a cliched statement.
Okay.
In fact.
Okay.
Yes. So it's overused. It has been overused now.
Okay.
चलो ये हो गए, ये पॉइंट्स हैं, ये आपने सारे वैसे पॉइंट्स बोल दिए. ओके
राइट मैम.
या सो लेट मी कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके शुड चिल्ड्रन बी टॉट लोकल हिस्ट्री और शुड दे बी टॉट वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री. दिस इज एन एसे क्वेश्चन इन आइल्स. शुड चिल्ड्रन बी टॉट लोकल हिस्ट्री और वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री?
बोथ.
हाँ तो बोल, दोनों की इंपॉर्टेंस बोल दो. आई थिंक चिल्ड्रन शुड बी टॉट बोथ. फिर बोलो अपना आंसर, स्पीक आउट द आंसर.
वेल आई थिंक चिल्ड्रन शुड बी टॉट बोथ लोकल हिस्ट्री एज वेल एज वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री, बिकॉज फ्रॉम लोकल हिस्ट्री दे वुड नो व्हाट हैज बीन डन इन देयर सिटी प्रीवियसली एंड दे कुड लुक फॉरवर्ड एंड टेक अ प्रॉपर स्टेप इन देयर लाइफ. World history is as well as important because they would know the what is going around inside the world, and if they try to relocate to some another country or another city, they should also be aware about that city's what happened earlier.
Okay, so you can say importance of local history, that they are connected to their roots, they know what has been there, and then for the world history, importance of local history. This file, I have shared this file with you. You can read it. Okay. And world history, because today children are belong to a global village. Mm. Okay. Global citizens banna hai, toh unko sari world ki history thodi bahut pata honi chahiye. What problems any country has faced or is facing, they should know. So they'll know where to go to and what to do when they go there, if they go at all. Okay. Like that. Okay. Next question. Should science be mandatory in schools? Should the subject of science be mandatory in schools? Who will answer?
Yes.
Bolo.
Yeah, ma'am. I will answer. Well, I think science should be mandatory in schools, because basic science is very important for having a better life. For example, learning maths. Learning physics or chemistry will help the child to understand about the small things happening inside home, where they can explain about some reactions like
you can give any example like why.
Yeah, like. Why
water becomes less when it is boiling?
Yes,
why water becomes less when it is boiling?
Yeah,
why
yes.
Evaporates? You know, think from a child's point of view. What will go? Achha, boil ho raha, pani kam ho gaya, pani khatam ho gaya. What has happened?
What is evaporation? So yes, he can learn about that. Yes. And the process of raining.
Things will
be always significant in students' life.
Yes.
That's all. So when it comes to examples, we know, but suddenly we will not get that is the issue.
Okay. So they'll also, through the study of science, they can also know the importance of animals and plants. You can say simple things like that. Okay. How plants grow, how animals are important, because that is also science. Zoology is also science. Botany is also science. Okay. Environmental science is also science, like that. Okay. Should the government invest more money in teaching science than other subjects? Who is going to answer this? Should the government invest more money in teaching science?
Ma'am, can I?
Sure.
Well, I believe that it is necessary that government should invest more money in teaching science to the students, because as such, government is motivating the student to learn the basic activities which are going around them. For example, if they are providing some good equipments in the labs, in the science lab, then the student should be able to do some more practical things in the lab and can come to know that how the things are happening around them. Besides
that,
you
know, in this question, very good, you are answering on the right track. See, the thing is, the question is, should the government invest more money in teaching science? So when you answer this question than other subjects, so you know, you, in a way, you want to say that other subjects are also important, but yes, the government should invest more money in science because science is more important than other subjects. Ye kehne se achha aap bolo ki science subjects ki jo teaching hai na, that is expensive as it is because it needs laboratories and all. So more money is needed. Otherwise, all subjects are important, but no laboratories are needed for teaching history, right? For teaching history or English or languages or any of mathematics or any other subject, but for sciences you need laboratories. So there is more money involved, even if the all subjects are equally important. Like that you can say. Okay. Right. Then you can say, while all subjects are important, of course science subjects require more money to be taught because these are practical subjects and they need laboratories and all. And also these subjects, as it is, we belong to an era of science and technology. You can answer that also. But this is the way, you know, I have answered this question with the, by disagreeing. I've said that other subjects are as important. So equal money should be allocated for all subjects. But you can always say more money to science. And then you can give this plea that science is a costly, you know, it's costly to teach science. It's costlier than other subjects to teach science. Okay.
You can also add in science, the, like point, because of science, we get like... technology.
Yes, of course, because of science we get to know many things. Okay, like that you can say. That is not it. That's perfectly okay. Right?
Okay, ma'am.
Chalo. Abhi hum to ye aaj aapko fir how is this class going? Are you liking it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then the next question, next essay, some people believe teenagers should concentrate on all. Okay, should teenagers concentrate on all school subjects or should they only study the subject that they have interest in? We'll answer this.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes.
I think students should focus on all subjects initially because basic understanding of all subjects are important. Other than this, after 10th grade or 8th grade, it should be allowed to focus on a particular subject where they have their interest.
Very good.
So which basically will help them to make their career in that particular school.
Yes. So that is perfectly okay. They should focus on all subjects. And if it comes in the discuss essay, again here the same question has been asked. That first question was that for science, for teenagers or for secondary school students. And this question is for university students. Should university students focus on one subject or on a range of subjects? So here, slight difference in the essay topic, but this question is with the university students in mind. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So here, Nora was there all the time with me, and this is the Bhoot, naughty Bhoot. Always naughty. Either they naughty. Look here. Look here. Look here. He's not bothered. He's only bothered about his bone.
They're so cute.
I've given different names. Naughty is KK and Nora is BB.
Okay.
Oh. Naughty is KK. KK stands for Kamina Kutta. And BB is BB Behen. See? She's so
BB. BB Behen abhi baith gaye saath.
He is BB Behen. And he is Naughty. Look here.
Chill kar rahe hain aapke saath baith ke.
Ye wo usko haath nahi laga sakti, uske muh mein haddi hai. Agar main haath bhi kara to usne mujhe lahu luhan kar dena.
Don't disturb mode chal gaya.
Huh?
Do not disturb mode.
Ah, D&D.
But it's good, ma'am. You have pets in home, like.
Yes. you know, my grandmother at any given time, she was in a farmhouse, 15 or 16 would be around her all the time.
Oh my God.
Okay. So what is the advantage of unpaid internship? What are the advantages and disadvantages of unpaid internships? You know, what are unpaid internships when students work in companies for 2 months or 6 months during their as part of their education? आपको पता है ना इंजीनियरिंग में एमबीएस में इंटर्नशिप्स होती हैं महीने दो महीने छह महीने की. यू नो दैट, आर यू अवेयर? दिस एसे इज देयर बोथ फॉर टीचिंग एंड फॉर एकेडमिक. ये दोनों के लिए है ये एसे. इसके पॉइंट्स बताओ. चलो, हु विल स्पीक आउट? अमित, आप ही बता देना अगर और कोई नहीं बोले तो.
ओके मैम. ओके,
किसी ने आंसर देना है कि नहीं?
मैं मैम.
हाँ बोलो.
There are various advantages of unpaid internships. Nowadays, people are not getting employment. So if this is a very good opportunity to learn a practical knowledge, which is not possible in college.
Very good.
And if one person is getting opportunity in an unpaid internship, they might get a permanent job in the same company. Other than this, they can understand the realistic problems which is going on in industry.
Very good. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Very good. Harsh, bahut achhe answers de rahe ho. Very nice. Okay. So, unpaid internship essays, they are both in the academic book and the GT book. Okay. So, when you talk about the advantages of unpaid internships, you can talk in terms of advantages to the student, advantages to the companies in which they get training, and advantages to the educational institutes. Okay. So you can talk like that, and then you can say everyone is benefited by them. So companies get workers for free. Educational institutes can, you know, raise their bar by advertising that they give unpaid internship. They provide internships to students in very good companies. Like that, this is one point for which many students join a particular university or college. Am I right?
I agree.
So like that you can say. And of course, to the students, there are advantages. Okay. Now tell me the importance of teaching handwriting to children. This is an essay, both in the academic and the GT book. Importance of teaching handwriting to children. Handwriting skills, handwriting. Okay, yes, Shima. Would you like to answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, answer it. I'm very happy most students are coming forward. Yes.
The main reason why handwritings are is important is that it is form of communication. When children learn how to write by hand, they also learn how to express themselves.
Very good.
Handwriting is so much more than simply putting words on the page. It is key part of learning to communicate with others. Writing is as important as speaking, as it is a medium of expression of thoughts.
Seema, आप अपना बोल रहे हो कि कहीं से पढ़ रहे हो?
नहीं, मैंने अभी कल मतलब दो दिन पहले ये ऐसे सबमिट किया है ना मैडम को, इसलिए मुझे पता था इसके आइडिया.
अच्छा ठीक है. और हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन की बात कर सकते हो. इट इम्प्रूव्स हैंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन. ओके, लाइक दैट यू कैन. वेरी गुड. ओके
मैम, देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड फॉर कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन हैंड एंड आई. ओ मैम, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर वर्ड?
Coordination.
Hand-eye coordination only I know. I don't know any other. It's not striking my mind.
Is it a motor development, something like that?
Yes.
What is it?
Motor development. I read somewhere that when you are using your fingers, motor development skills or something like that.
Motor skills. Those are small muscles of the hand. Okay, they develop when the kid uses a joystick or something like that.
So when they write also, it will improve, no? Their fingers
yes,
will...
Yes, that will improve the motor skills. Yes, those okay. are motor skills. M-O-T-O-R, motor
yes,
skills.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, that hand-eye coordination is different, you know?
Okay, ma'am.
Your brain is giving a, you know, you draw something signals. Or you write something, your brain is giving a signal, okay, to the hand, and your hand is following the signal of the brain. So that's hand-eye coordination, okay, like that.
Ma'am, we can add one more point that some students can develop different careers like painter, artist, and calligraphy.
Yes, you can so add that can point, of course, you can add that point. We had a calligrapher in my, you know, online, among my online students who had got some award from the, you know, PM. It was really great for his calligraphy. Okay. Great artist. Okay. Okay. What is the importance of traditional letter writing? And will the art of traditional letter writing die out completely? These are my questions.
Mm-hmm.
Traditional letter writing, will it completely disappear or will it be, will it still maintain its place? आप लोगों आपने कभी चिट्ठी लिखी है किसी को हाथ से ईमेल की yes. बात नहीं कर रही
हाँ, लिखी हाँ, है बिफोर 2003-4
अच्छा उससे लिखी। पहले लिखी है ओके
okay.
मैं जब मेडिकल कॉलेज पढ़ती थी ना द मोमेंट आई यूज्ड टू कम इन द हॉस्टल आफ्टर अटेंडिंग द कॉलेज पहला काम होता था एक टेबल लगा होता था हमारे बाहर हॉल में अंदर एंटर करते ही हॉस्टल के हॉल में उसके ऊपर सबकी चिट्ठियां ऐसे खिलर पड़ी होती थी तो पहली नजर मेरी जाती थी कि मेरी कोई चिट्ठी आई और मेरे को लेटर्स मेरे नाना जी लिखते थे और मेरे दादाजी लिखते थे और मैंने बहुत साल वो लेटर संभाली फिर मैंने संभाल के बड़े साल संभाली बीच बीच में मैं दोबारा पढ़ लेती थी फिर बहुत सालों के बाद मैंने देखा कि अब किसी को इंटरेस्ट नहीं है इनमें तो मैंने थोड़ा वो मिनिमलिस्टिक अप्रोच की लाइफ जो है वो अभी प्लान वो कर रही हूँ कि जो चीज नहीं चाहिए उसको डिस्कार्ड कर रही हूँ और जो मतलब कुछ रख के क्या करना है तो ये सोच के ना मैं चीजें जो खत्म करने के चक्कर में मैंने देखा कि किसी को इंटरेस्ट नहीं होता बट आई रियली यूज्ड टू लुक फॉरवर्ड टू दोज लेटर्स व्हेन आई रिसीव्ड देम एंड बड़ा अच्छा लगता था मेरी चिट्ठियां बहुत आती थी बिकॉज माई नाना जी वॉज वेरी पर्टिकुलर कि मुझे हर दूसरे दिन एक चिट्ठी वहां पे पहुंच जाए लिखते रहते थे और मैं रिप्लाईज भी करती थी उनको और हालांकि मैं सिर्फ 2 hours दूर थी अपने घर से पर हॉस्टल में रहना होता था और पढ़ना बहुत होता था इसलिए घर जाना तो महीने में एक बार या ज्यादा से ज्यादा 2 बार होता था सो दैट इज यू नो ट्रेडिशनल लेटर्स अब तो बहुत कम हो गई हैं वेरी 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 रेयर नाउ
बट मैम लेट मी ऐड अ पॉइंट आई हैव अ फ्रेंड आई मीन माय फ्रेंड वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड शी हैव दिस हैबिट ऑफ राइटिंग लेटर एंड शी हैव क्रिएटेड फ्रेंड्स ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड आई मीन In every country, she has someone who will receive a letter from her during Christmas or New Year. She will write a small letter to them. Okay. She's doing this for years now, and her name has came in papers. And actually,
I have a friend Elaine Phillips. She's an American, and every month I receive her handwritten letter. Ever since 2006, when I met her first, 15 years have passed. Okay, one letter I've received from her every month. Okay, and I've put up her letters. I've made a collage of her letters on a wall. Okay, so you know, when I just stand there and do something, I go through a few words written by her, and it's very, very, you know, it gives a feeling of, you know, that very nice feeling you get emotionally.
Emotionally
warm feeling in your mind. Okay. That is it. So that was today's class. I hope you enjoyed it. And we'll get back with such questions next week because after that, we are going to have new cue cards. If we come to know, all of you, please keep your eyes and ears and everything open for the new cue cards which will be added. So I'll need those, and quickly we'll have to compile them before the first week of February, by the first week of January. As you come across any cue card which is asked to any of your friends or anybody you know, or any place, but you know, online sites are going to be very, very, they may be wrong also. So if authentic information is there, then share it in the groups. That is a request to all of you. And see you tomorrow then. Okay, bye.